What's up, guys? It's your boy Patrick from Behringer from the sunny climes of Banaheim for NAMM 2020. Today we've got another little surprise for you. We're going to go meet one of our new lead engineers. He's working on a little nifty project you might be interested in. Let's go meet him. Do you want to introduce yourself?
Yeah, my name's Rob Keeble. So I'm the founder and chief engineer of AM Synths, a small boutique analog modular company based in the UK. So earlier last year, around about June time, Yuli was looking for engineers, analog engineers, to help him with some of the products. So I reached out to Yuli to say there was some synergy between the work I've been doing over the last 10 years, re-engineering ARP and other synths, and see if I could help the projects at Behringer. And that went well, and I've started getting involved in a number of projects now at Behringer to help the analog design. I've been involved in the ARP since for the last 10, 20 years, recreating them, re-engineering them, understanding how they worked, in particular the early stages from 1969 right the way through into the 2600 and since beyond there, like the Odyssey. So my experience really has been building these as modules and creating them and recreating them so they sound better, understanding how they could be improved. So I started in analog synths by building a kit because things weren't affordable. So I built that up and got it working and played that in bands, and then really went through a tape recording time period, again recording to tape, using it for delays, and got in so original synthesizers then. I then took a break from analog synths until I went to EMU Systems. I visited them in 2002, met up with the team there, Dave Rossum and Scott Wedge, and that really introduced me into modular synthesizers, which I hadn't really seen because they're so expensive. So after playing around with the EMU modular, I decided to go and build one, which was my first attempt at building synths, and then went into designing and thinking through other designs such as ARP and Moog designs as well as Roland. So I've generally been working on analog engineering since about 2002. So my background really the last 20 years building stuff, analog modules, refining them, thinking how they work, but also concentrating on kind of creating modules that are really high quality and sound good. And that's kind of what I've learned over the last few years, is how to engineer things that they sound good and that musicians really like them. And that's been the basis of AM Synths, is a low volume production, but producing modules that customers really enjoy and like because of the high quality.
So when you decided to reach out to Yuli, what was the catalyst for that?
Catalyst is really, as an analog engineer, really wanting to bring designs forward and get them into customers' hands. So running AM Synths, I realized that I could only produce a couple of hundred modules a year. Whilst working with Yuli, I could produce many hundreds, if not thousands, of modules. So the manufacturing capability of Behringer is really unique and really exciting to work with. Also, the ability to get products to market quicker than I perhaps could do with my own skills, because there's only one person I can actually latch into a team. But the real key is to bring in some really interesting analog synths from the past, re-engineer them, get them out to customers at a good price point, and people having fun with synthesizers.